Ugh.
HQ to Alpha, we have your mission brief. Rescue the
hostages slow
on the
walking.
First and seventh floors, then get out of the building. As soon as all teams are clear, we will commence bombing.
I said this before, but it really does. Oh, this is a raid stage in Revelations 2. Now I know what this is from. God damn it! Stop! Fuck! See how frustrating this would be if I was playing on a higher difficulty? Because I would be just taking way more damage. But there's no extra challenge, it's just, oh, the bullshit that the game is imposing on me. Now I've died and I have to redo the section. It's not like it's any more, like, satisfying of a challenge. Like, look, watch this. I'm holding down left trigger to aim. Automatically sticks to cover. Why? Why has it gotta be that way? God damn it! Unstick me fucking cover! I'm trying to aim here, and this shit... very hunk. Oh, I thought that was an explosive barrel. It looks like it. It's red. I thought it might be an anything, but it's not. It's not a thing. What is this fucking, like, shooty action-y fucking sequence? God damn. I don't know, I don't hate the idea of it. I like the idea, because the BSAA was an established thing, and I do think I like the goofiness of, like, bioterrorism is just a thing that people have to fucking, like, that is a known threat in this setting. It reminds me of, like, I like the idea of settings where, like, I don't know, like, vampires or something is a known thing. And whenever a vampire fucking insurgency pops up, like, the government's, like, send in the agency that is responsible for dealing with this supernatural threat. Like, Helsing, for example. That's a good example. I guess. I don't know. There's examples. Fucking stop doing that! But I just think it's funny, like, oh shit, ever since the thing happened, now this is a huge deal in this setting, and we have, and like, people keep doing it everywhere in the world, and we have to, like, organize a fucking organization whose entire purpose and functionality is to deal with this threat whenever it pops up. And so the idea of, oh, this, like, all this, get the fuck out of my way. The idea of Umbrella was doing all this research on viruses and BOWs and dumb shit like that for who knows how long in secret, and no one ever knew. And then the Spencer Estate happened. And then the Raccoon City incident happened. And after that, the fucking, like, God damn it! Like, the lid was blown open on bioterrorism. And now that's just a fucking thing that everyone has to deal with now. You guys fucking suck. Why are you even here? Just getting in my way. That's all you're here. That's all you're doing. Everyone's just standing in my way. Wow, that's really dumb. This always reminds me of a thing, is, are they able to turn that off? Like, when they do the transformation into a weird spider guy? Like, can they just turn back into a human afterwards? That's watermelon. Watermelon! Because otherwise that would seem to present a problem. Like, the instant you pop that in order to deal with the threat, now you're stuck that way forever. Right? Wouldn't that make you be like, I really don't want to have to resort to this, because otherwise I'm totally screwed for the rest of my life. Like, I have no capability to just live a normal civilian life now, because I'm a monster mash for the rest of my life. The worst example of that was, get the fuck out of my way, you stupid cocksucker, was in 5, where there was like a sleazy, like, black market, like, weapons dealer kind of guy. And the main characters were after him. And they would chase him through, like, a good couple chapters of the game. And when they finally catch him, like, they have him dead to rights, he pops the fucking virus, the Ouroboros, in that game. And turns into a monster mat, and turns into like a giant fish. Like, you fight him on a boat, and it's really bad, and it's not a fun fight at all. And he's like a big fishy guy, and he's making like dumb remarks. He's like, I'm ready for my close-up, or whatever, and it was really gay. And you fight him, and it's like, okay, what if he won? Like, he's a giant monster fish guy. What if he won? What if he beat us? What if he killed us? Then what? Like, is he gonna go back to being a fucking black market? Is he gonna go back to being a black market gunrunner, dude? Like, how would he be able to do that as a giant fish? He would just have to, like, start swimming in the ocean. And be like, and eat and live off of brine and minnows from now on. That seems really silly. So you'd think there must be a way to turn it off and go back into like your normal human form, right? There must be. Otherwise, that's fucking stupid. That's why I always thought Wesker was fucking cheating, because Wesker, he pops his virus, and he just stays looking like a normal, regular dude. But now he has Matrix flash step powers.
Delta 1 to 8,
and he can flash step all over the place and punch you really hard.
All hostages on the 54 secured. Leaving the building now.
Okay, that just leaves us.
Like, why is his the only virus?
It stopped. Now what?
Where he gets to remain, like, looking like a regular person.
I can get through the ceiling if you give me a hand.
And it's this dumb, like, fucking... It's this magic virus where he's like, I'm gonna inject myself with it, and then let myself get killed by the tyrant, and me dying will activate the virus and turn me into a virus guy. And then that virus is never mentioned again. Like, no one ever uses that again. It's just always new strains of the T-virus. Oh. And I guess, to be fair, no one ever brings up the fucking G-virus after Birkin uses it either. But that actually makes sense, because it was kind of implied that there were only a handful of samples of the G-virus.
Come on, we can take them!
Take them.
Shut up.
Follow me!
Like, wow. There was the one Birkin used on himself. There was the one Hunk got. There was the one in Sherry's pendant. There was the one Annette was running around with. There were a couple samples of the G-virus. There were a couple samples, and I'm pretty sure it's implied that Ada Wong gets out of Raccoon City with her sample of the G-Virus and hands it over to the organization that she works for. And Hunk definitely makes it out of Raccoon City with the G-Virus and gives it to Umbrella. So theoretically, the G-Virus could have showed up again. You'd think it would have been mentioned. Hell, technically, even the, like, American government has samples of the G-Virus because fucking Sherry Birkin got knocked up by her monster daddy. And she even got injected with the, what was it, a vaccine.
HQ here, copy that.
And that actually gets mentioned in this game for some reason, being knocked up by the G-Virus and being given the vaccine magically gives her magic regeneration powers. Like, she gets a huge spike of metal through her body and they rip it out and she's like, yeah, it's fine. And it just heals up right in front of their eyes. And it's kind of goofy. Oh, neither of these? Neither of these. Okay then. Whatever. Here, skip.
Ready?
Get out of my way. You're so frustrating. What the fuck? I'm not aiming! Why did it do that? It automatically put me into aim mode. Without me holding the left trigger.
First floor hostage secured.
Copy that, Alpha. Now clear out of there.
Yeah, it's kind of dumb that it's always just the T-Virus over and over again making people into zombies. For some reason, they never use any of the other viruses after the first game that they're introduced in. Actually, no, that's not true, because the T-Veronica virus gets brought up again in Darkseid Chronicles. So what the fuck? But anyway, I do like the idea of, like, okay, the Raccoon City incident blew the lid open on this virus research shit and biological weapons development that Umbrella was doing, and now a whole bunch of people kind of got in on that, and you can kind of see the idea of, okay, Umbrella gets liquidated and shut down by the US government. There were still a ton of researchers for fucking Umbrella who got, you know, lost their jobs. They're still gonna take all the shit that they were researching and take it with them.
We don't want to be here when those birds show up.
Plus, all of these organizations are, like, stealing shit from Umbrella, like the guys that Ada Wong works for and shit. So everyone's getting their hands on dumb zombie viruses and BOWs.
This isn't gonna last long.
Where am I supposed to go? Upstairs? Okay. So the idea of, like, bioterrorism being the... Did I die? Okay, I magically get teleported into the stairwell to get crushed, even though I had run out of the stairwell and onto the next floor of the building. Fuck this game, man.
Guess they don't care that we're still in here.
God damn it! Stop fucking ripping control of the fucking camera! Oh, here we go.
This building isn't gonna last long.
Fuck. Anyway, you can see the idea of, like, okay, bioterrorism becomes a thing. Like, every third world country and .com can get their hands on fucking a virus or a couple of, like, discount hunters and start running around doing shit like this, right? You can see incidents like this kicking off from time to time in various different countries. And I think, like, in that first level, it's Jake and Sherry. He was part of this mercenary group that got, like, tricked and given a bunch of viruses, and the BSA had to be deployed to deal with it. And it's just, like, little dumb incidents of motherfuckers who, like, bought a vial of virus off of fucking eBay or Craigslist, and you gotta send the BSAA to deal with the fucking situation. I like that idea. You know what's fucking stupid? It's fucking Neo Umbrella. That's fucking retarded. Oh, my amnesia, my PTSD is making me get a migraine in my head, like a sharp, stinging pain. That's causing me to fucking grab my head and fall to my knees. Shut up. Goddamn. All of these chapters are so tedious, too. Like, they're all about an hour long, and they just feel like such a slog to get through. Because there's no falling action. It's just, like, mounting, like, tension and action fucking the entire way through. They never give you time to breathe. There's never those moments like in RE4 where, okay, you fight the regenerators and that's a really tense, like, nail-biting kind of thing. Because it's a scary monster and it's a new threat that you have to deal with. But then what immediately happens afterwards is you run into a room and it's a fucking crane minigame. And you pick up motherfuckers with a crane and drop them in a hole to get them out of the way. And it's just goofy and silly. And that's deliberate. It's like, okay, here's a tense situation. Now here's something to take the edge off. And you have to, like, okay, we're chilling out now. That an organization named Neo Umbrella just claimed responsibility. That's really fucking gay. I know what you're thinking.
Yeah. It's Raccoon City all over again.
That's all the news I've got. Now it's your turn to help me. I need to know what's in that cathedral.
I've got suits printing down my neck for info.
Suits?
Specifically? Derek C. Simmons, National Security Advisor.
Oh, just fuck you. Fucking look at that guy. Like, you can just look at that guy and be like, yeah, he's evil. I mean, come on. I mean, who is fucking surprised? You live in the world of Resident Evil. At some point, you have to start judging people by their appearances, you know? And be like, okay, get that guy out of the room. Are you fucking kidding me? Look at his hair. Just get rid of him.
No!
How? How does that happen? How does that happen? That's ridiculous. Oh, awesome. Hello, can you reload? Can you reload the gun? Thanks. I appreciate that.
We're going over!
These zombies are the most frustrating to fight. Like, I would much rather fight the Jim Joes, whatever they're fucking called. Because at least they fucking react to you shooting them. These zombies just no-sell every- Oh, God. Fuck you. They are dead. They're just dead. Like, you don't survive that. Every single bone in their body is broken. They are suffering internal bleeding. They probably have a concussion. They are no longer alive. What?
This
can't
be infection.
Oh my god!
Die like this.
Oh, cut my life into pieces! This is my last resort! Suffocation! No breathing! Don't give a fuck! Give a cut my arm bleeding! Fuck you, Leon! Jesus Christ!
Oh, they escaped the infection!
Fucking shut up!
Elena! Are you
this
okay?
This is so bad!
For whatever reason...
Slow walking the video game!
Cemetery.
Slow walking. How is Leon's campaign the worst one so far? Like, even Chris's... wasn't this frustrating. Wow. Look at this, we got fucking... cool cult guy with a robe. And lady. And of course, I've never understood this thing of the T-virus making zombies out of corpses in cemeteries. This happens in, Oh my god! Because that happened in, what was it? Code Veronica, also. Where you walk out of the first room and you're in a cemetery and zombies literally sprout out of the ground. Okay, these are like traps or something. And start trying to attack you. And that doesn't make sense, considering what the T-virus is supposed to be. Like, the T-virus can't reanimate the dead and make them into zombies. I mean, that's a cool idea that is a fun thing to do in a zombie game. But that doesn't make sense considering the logic of what Resident Evil's explanation for zombies is. And that's always a thing for me, is the distinction between, like, Resident Evil-style zombies and Walking Dead-style zombies. Because I hate Walking Dead-style zombies. I think that's dumb. Like, it's basically just magic. They're magic zombies. No matter how you die, you become a zombie. That's fucking stupid. Like, it doesn't matter if you get bit. It doesn't matter what happens. If you die and your head is still intact, zombie.
You got it.
Even if you've been decapitated, as long as your head is still intact, your decapitated head will reanimate as a zombie. It's fucking the dumbest shit. Like, that doesn't make sense. It's just magic. It's magic. It's magic zombies. That's what it is. Like, dead bodies are being reanimated via magic.
I guess there are worse things than chasing a dog through a cemetery.
Yeah, it could be chasing us.
It's just dumb. Like, I don't know. Call me an asshole, but the idea of a virus turning people into zombies if it infects you, the virus just gets into the air and someone gets infected and they sneeze into your open mouth and you get infected. I don't know. Just the biological terror of, like, contagious substances infecting you and turning you into a zombie is way more scary to me. And I don't know, more believable, I guess. I mean, it's all dumb. But to a degree, it just feels less retarded. I don't know. Like, my willing suspension of disbelief can buy the idea of virus zombies better than the idea of fucking Just shut up. If you die, you turn into a zombie. Shut up. Just shut up, though. Shut up. Plus, it reminds me of that movie, what was it? I think it was actually called Contagion or something. It's this Japanese movie about, like, the worst possible thing that could ever happen in a hospital, where a bunch of hospital employees at the end of, like, a fucking 16-hour shift and are just at that point where they don't care anymore and they're overworked, and a fucking outbreak happens and the whole hospital gets quarantined and people just start getting infected and sick, and it's just the most disturbing body horror shit you've ever seen in your life. Oh, Jesus. And on easy mode, like, the quick time events to getting out of grabs like that is so not as bad, and it goes by really quickly.
Now let's get to that cathedral.
And it didn't do as much damage. Like, on normal mode, I would be grabbed like that, and I would instantly lose an entire block of damage, and they would start doing more damage to my other blocks of health the longer it took for me to shake them off. And it takes more than 3 times as long as it did there to shake you off in normal mode. That's what I'm talking about. It feels like there should be an extra notch of difficulty in between amateur and normal. It feels like normal is hard, and fucking amateur is way too easy. And it's like this creepy, shitty infection, and people just start fucking sneezing into each other's, like, fucking open wounds, and it's like the most disturbing, wince-inducing shit you've ever seen in your life.
Okay, we're in.
And I really go for shit like that. Like, horror like that is the fucking best. Yeah.
Leon, are you alright?
Really fucked up body horror, like The anyway. Thing, like John Carmack's The Thing, is my favorite horror movie. I do like, again, I've mentioned this, but I hate co-op games, but I love in co-op games where you and your co-op partner get separated and have to go through different, like, sections of a level removed from each other like that.
Another locked door.
Another one. And actually, like, I kinda liked RE4 getting away from the viruses thing and going for parasites. Because there are actually parasites in real life that do stuff like what the Las Plagas did. Where it would... Yeah. I like the fucking counterattack prompts like that. Where they would, like, burrow into your body and affect your brain and start mind controlling you. Shit
alive.
Like, fuck you.
Nice. Thanks.
Good job.
Appreciate it.
This way.
Roger.
This way.
You got it.
Fall back.
You got it.
This way.
Roger.
Thanks. Thanks. Nice.
Oh my god, it's so dumb.
Thanks for that.
Well, they actually control your brain. And, like, in the animal kingdom at least, I don't think anything does that to humans. Aside from, like, Toxoplasma Gondii and shit like that. So, like, using that in Resident Evil feels totally natural, and it evolved the gameplay by having the parasites be unique enemies with, like, head popping and whatnot. And then say what you want about it, because I have and will, but RE5 expanded on that by having the Ouroboros. And the Ouroboros was based on the fucking Las Plagas in-universe. And it was an active improvement over the Las Plagas, because the Las Plagas had to be injected with, like, a syringe, and you had to wait for it to gestate and hatch, and it had the most inconsistent gestation time ever. Look at this fucking Joker. Look at this fucking guy. What a fucking tryhard. Come on. Ah, fucked it up. I was trying to do the counter move. So dumb. And Leon doing shit like that makes even less sense when they're characterizing him as being all dour.
Thanks. You coming to this cathedral with me or what?
And gloomy.
You got it.
And meanwhile, he's like doing wrestling moves on motherfuckers.
I see it. Hurry.
Sorry, but I can accept RE4 Leon doing suplexes and shit like that on people way more than this Leon. This Leon seems like an asshole. Like a stick in the mud. It just seems weird to change his character like that. But hey, again,
hello?
Leon's character of being like a gum-chewing American action hero wouldn't fit in this fucking gay-ass fucking like try-hard, edgy, taking itself way too seriously fucking story. These fucking zombies are just the most inconsistent enemies. They don't appear to register any damage. Oh, I love that, by the way. That's part of the cheap bullshit that I was talking about, where I'm in the middle of fucking hitting them with my melee attack, and then they just decide that, no, I want to hit you with my melee attack instead. And even though there's, like, no tell, there's, like, no animation of, like, them lunging forward or whatever, they'll just automatically grab you like that. Because they just decided that it's time for you to take damage now. Like, now is the time that you take damage, because that's what I say. And it's the most aggravating fucking shit. But again, on easy, it's fine because you don't take that much damage.
That was someone in there with a little backbone.
Oh, open the door! Ow!
What was I saying? Oh, the Ouroboros was a fucking natural evolution on the concept of the Lost Planet. Yeah! And I figured out you can dodge, by the way, also. All you have to do is hold down aim and then press X, and you'll dodge roll out of the way like that. And you can avoid damage that way. So, I learned things. Again, see, like, this game's way easier to deal with when it's not being frustrating to play, in addition to all of the other problems that there are with it.
Are you... Sorry, guys. We're not rescue workers.
Fucking Ouroboros was a great that you know that.
You want to tell me what's down there?
How do you know about that, by the way? God, this is the most suspicious bitch. What a nothing character. You're, like, the worst. Like, the... how terrible this character is. And it's even worse because she's a female character in Resident Evil, and that would be bad enough on its own, but, like, female characters in Resident Evil are usually really good. And there's a lot of them! Like, this game, like, this series is known. I don't know if it's known, but if you actually look at it, there's a fucking ton of really good female characters in this franchise. There's Jill, Claire, Ada. I'm like, you have to go through each game. Oh, Rebecca. I like Rebecca. Who? Fucking, like, Resident Evil 2, almost every principal fucking character in the cast was a female character. Claire, Ada, and Annette. And Annette was a fucking crazy bitch. Sherry, also. Holy shit.
My son Marco, he's in the PSAA. You watch. He'll be here with the whole army any minute now.
There we go. Three was just Jill again. Four had Ashley, and she sucked. So you're marginally worse than Ashley. Good job. At least Ashley hid in a fucking bin when I told her to get the fuck out of my way. At least when I told Ashley to fuck off, she would fuck off.
This isn't just part of the decor.
You're right. There's more here than meets the eye.
Transformers. So, like, a shitty female character in a series that has so many great female characters stands out all the more. Sheva in 5. Again, I really like Sheva.
There are stairs under this.
I thought she was a good addition, even though she was just thrown in there and kind of half-assed as a co-op thing.
Figure something out.
I thought she was pretty cool. Her character, she had the purple color. She had the color purple. My God, words are hard to have. Because every character has in Resident Evil has a principal color, which I think is one of the best features about it. And Sheva's was purple, and I like that. I don't know.
What are we doing here?
I don't know, I just thought Sheva was cool. And then you had in Revelations, you had that fucking skanky slut bitch who wanted to fuck Chris, even though he was clearly gay. He's not really gay, but he is a potato.
Identical to
she wanted to fuck a. She wanted to fuck a potato. Let's be honest here. Show. Fucking. What was her name? Shit, the monster. What was her name? I want to say Rachel. There was a character who, like, she had dumb hair over her face. Nothing. She became a big fan favorite character.
The two motherly.
Oh my God! No shit! Shut the fuck up! God damn it. Ugh. I forget her fucking name, but, like, she becomes a monster who, like, pursues you through the entire rest of the game. She becomes the nemesis of that game, and it was really fun.
Are you okay?
And a lot of people really liked her for some reason. And she even got added in into Revelations 2. As a character you can play in the raid mode. And then Revelations 2 has Moira and... Who's the little girl? The little girl character. I forget her name, but she's dumb. She's a dumb little girl character. Kind of like Sherry. Somewhere. And then, hey, in this game, Sherry comes back, and she's a cool character. And then Moira... I don't like her dialogue because it seemed weirdly out of place in a Resident Evil game for characters to be swearing so much. Like, Resident Evil has never been a vulgar. Defeat the statue trap. Listen to that music trying to evoke Resident Evil 4. Listen to this music trying to evoke the music from Resident Evil 4. Goddamn.
This is gonna get a little bit dicey.
I liked Moira's fucking character development, where she started out kind of having a phobia of guns, and then, like, had to get over it, and then she becomes really cool, and, like, has an interesting relationship with her dad. And it added things to, like, Claire and her relationship with fucking Chris.
Wouldn't want to miss out on all the fun.
Anyway, like, Revelations 2 is really good. And the villain was Alex Wesker, like Albert Wesker's sister or whatever, because it got mentioned in Resident Evil 5 that there were a ton of different Weskers, and one of them was Alex, and they made it like, hey, Alex can be a boy's name or girl's name, so let's make Alex a girl. And she was a pretty cool villain, and she was really into Kafka, but in a way that you could tell she didn't really get what Kafka was all about. She was just a hipster. It's always great when people, like, quote shit like Kafka-esque, and it's like, no, Kafka thought he was fucking the funniest shit ever. Like, people, like, talk about Kafka stories like they're tragedies, but Kafka thought his stories were really funny. He would read his stories to his friends and be laughing uproariously while doing so. Okay, then. Anyway. So, that's my point. Fucking Helena fucking is a shitty character, and it's inexcusable in Resident Evil to have a shitty female character. Because even when a character is, like, kind of a bitch, they're still a pretty good kid. Hello, are you going to do something here? Oh. I get it. It's a hint. It made it seem like there was something that she had to do on that side of the room. But okay, I understand. That's actually pretty clever. And I miss when these games had dumb puzzles. This game does not have any of that. I mean, to be fair, again, they really started to get away from that in RE4, so I can't be hating. But I miss it, because again, I've been playing Resident Evil 2 a lot lately. Because, I don't know, doing the videos on Resident Evil 4 put me in that mood for the series, hence why I'm doing this. There was a charm to it. There was a goofy, dumbness to. And again, it would be better if the game, you know, was aware of it. I don't know if it would necessarily be better, but I mean, like, it's better to have something like Resident Evil 4, where the game is self-aware about its own silliness, rather than having shit like this. Shit like Resident Evil 5 was
loud and clear,
to a degree, on the same level of taking itself too seriously. Old riddle. I have to figure it out. Shut up. Stop ripping control away from me! God damn it! Fuck. That is such a massive pet peeve of mine in games, you have no idea. How much it frustrates me when a game just rips control out of my hands like that. Am I missing something? It's weird to say, it's weird to, like, think about it too, because like the older games, they didn't necessarily take themselves all that seriously either. That's why a remake is considerably less enjoyable, because it didn't have the goofy, shitty voice acting that the original game did. I don't know, I just like shittier, like, dumb voice acting that's amusing, that you can laugh at, rather than just nothing. Either fuck up so hard that it's funny, or like try and fuck up on purpose and point at yourself and be like, yeah, we fucked up, isn't that funny? Don't like kind of not fuck up, but to the point that it's nothing special. What the fuck am I supposed to do? So five bells loud and clear. Yeah, I get it. I only see three bells. There's one, two. Oh, shit. Okay. I see it now. And that one.
That's all of them. Kinda feel bad shooting antiques.
If you play fucking Code Veronica, that game is also fucking taking the piss. And it's so, like, it's so over the top that you're like, someone knew what they were fucking doing here. This is so dumb. It can't have been on accident. Whereas you have, like, Remake, which was kind of taking itself too seriously to be enjoyable, but it still had some funny moments of over-the-top stupid bullshit. Like, my favorite line is, like, in the Chris route, where Wesker's showing off the Tyrant, and Chris is like, Wesker, you've gone senile. Wait, is that from Remake? Or was that, am I just thinking of the original game? I'm thinking of the original game. Oh my fucking god. Resident Evil, I don't know what to do with you. I swear to god. So, good job killing everyone in this church, guys. I think it was more of a rhetorical question. Oh, it's the fog. Okay. Good job killing everyone in the church, idiots. Are you okay? Kick back, son. Oh my god. Yeah, let's jump down into the fog that's causing the zombie outbreak. Why can't I? Okay. Rather than sniping them from a distance. Like, yeah, you breathe in some gas and you become a zombie. That's fucking scary, man. That's some fucked up shit right there. Fuck this, oh, you die for any reason and you're a zombie now, fuck you. That's dumb. You're dumb. Get out of my face. Get out of my face with your face. Holy shit, Ouroboros. The reason Ouroboros is better than fucking Las Plagas. And again, like, oh shit, you're alive. Okay, stay here and don't die. Is because, like, Wesker got a sample of Las Plagas and, like, started doing shit with it. God damn it.
Don't panic, people. Just move away from it.
Yeah, no shit, idiots.
We'll take care of this.
Literally everyone just get out of the way and let the main characters do it. Otherwise you're just getting in the way. Or he got the fuck on Las Plagas and was like, okay, let's make this not shitty. And Ouroboros was like, you could just shove it into someone's face. You didn't need to inject an egg into a motherfucker and wait for it to gestate. You could just shove a fucking thing into their face and be like, fuck you, you're a zombie now. Suck my dick. And being able to go, fuck you, you're a zombie now, suck my dick, is a vast improvement over the fucking, like, 3 days it took Leon to not become a zombie in fucking RE4. And it gave him time to fucking, like, get rid of it. So that's way scarier, someone, like, coming up to you and just shoving some shit in your mouth before you can realize what's going on, and suddenly you're a fucking Majinji. And even then, I think, like, the entire idea of his plot at the end of that game was he wanted to achieve complete global saturation. And somehow, like, make Ouroboros airborne and just drop tanks of it all over the country and turn everyone into a Majinji. And again, that's a good fucking evil plan. It's way better than... What was Sadler's plan? His plan was like, I'm gonna infect the president's daughter and then make her head pop off in front of everyone so that everyone knows that we're cool guys who have dumb parasite powers. Fucking so stupid, Sadler.
All right. Ready?
Yeah.
But again, like, that brought this, like, really dumb problem of fucking Resident Evil 5, again, taking itself way too seriously, while at the same time having a fucking antagonist that you couldn't possibly take seriously because his motivations were fucking stupid. It's this cognitive dissonance that does not result in entertainment. There's a way to do it where it results in entertainment,
and it's for us right now.
Not always
on our own.
Like, possible to achieve on purpose.
I think this panel and the numbers on the doors are connected. I won't be able to force this one open.
Ugh.